everyone, it's Justin again. We get to learn about the segment addition postulate in this lesson. Mia drew you a little hint here as to what the segment addition postulate is. Thanks, Mia. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to apply the segment addition postulate to solve for unknown values. First, we'll learn what the segment addition postulate is. Then we'll complete two examples that use the segment addition postulate. I have a question for you. Do you think that the length of segment AB and the length of segment BC add up to equal the length of segment AC? So, for example, if AB is 5 units and BC is 7 units, would you say that AC is 12 units? I bet you're thinking no, and that's right. AB plus BC actually add up to be more than AC. What about now, if we move point B down a little bit? Nope. AB and BC are still greater than AC. How about now, if B moves down even more? Still not equal. How far down would we have to move point B for this to become an equal sign? When could these numbers actually apply and be true? Well, point B would have to move down so far that it's actually on segment AC. Let's do a little rearranging now that we've moved point B down. And now we get to write an equal sign here like we wanted. This, my friends, is the segment addition postulate. It says, given a line segment with endpoints A and C, point B lies on the segment if and only if AB plus BC equals AC. Let me fill you in on a few other details. You may have been wondering what a postulate is. Well, it's basically a mathematical statement that we can accept as true without having to prove it. Also, did you notice that I wasn't drawing segment symbols when I was writing the segment names? That's because when we're talking about measurements or lengths of segments, we don't have to write those symbols. Another way to write this with the segment symbols is to put an M in front, which means the measure. When we put an M in front of something in math, it lets us know that we're talking about the measure of it, like degrees for angles, or in this case, length for segments. This reads, the measure of segment AB plus the measure of segment BC equals the measure of segment AC. It's basically a math grammar thing, but we're gonna write ours the shorter way. I just wanted to show you what this means so you'll know it if you ever see it. Oh. And one more thing, our points don't have to be labeled A, B, and C. We can use any letters we want. Anyways, that's definitely enough background information. It's time to complete some examples. Here's an example that uses the segment addition postulate. It says, if JL equals 23, find JK. As you can see in this picture, we already have an expression that represents JK. When the directions say to find JK, we're wanting to find an actual distance or measurement for the length. We know from the segment addition postulate that JK plus KL equals JL. We can substitute our expression for JK into the formula along with our expression for KL. And we know that JL is 23, so we can substitute that in too. Ah, I see algebra here. Why don't you pause the video and see if you remember how to solve this for x. 4x and 2x combine to be 6x, and positive 3 minus 7 is negative 4. Then, We add 4 to both sides of the equation. Divide by 6. Since 27 over 6 is such a nice decimal, we may as well write it as 4.5. What we just found here is the value of x. But is that what we were asked to find? No, we were asked to find jk. We now have to substitute 4.5 into our expression for jk to get our final answer. This gives us 21 for the length of jk. We can write our final answer and be confident that we found what we were looking for. Let's do one more example where a drawing or visual isn't made for us. We're only given a description and we're told to find the value of x. Pause the video here and set up a drawing on your paper to represent this. Then, see if you can set up an equation and solve. Here's my drawing to represent this. What do you think? Does it match yours pretty well? And here's my equation. I substituted in the expressions for PQ here, QR here, and PR right there. Now, let's combine like terms that are on the same side of the equation by adding 5x and 4x to get 9x, and adding negative 1 and 8 to get 7. Now, we can move all the x terms to one side of the equation. I'm going to subtract 9x from both sides, and then subtracting 2 from both sides will give us the answer. So, did we find what we were asked to find in the original question, or do we need to substitute this x value back in somewhere? Here, the original directions just say to find the value of x, so we are done. Now you know what the segment addition postulate is and how to use it to solve for unknowns. See you next time. Hey.